this hinges off the last question, which was about, you know, having a vision. And it sounds like you tend to keep it fairly general, not too specific. And you made that compelling comment about iterate often and that being a process. Can you talk a little bit about what that looked like for you? As you went along, I'm assuming your vision shaped or changed in some way, in a dynamic way. And the iteration helped.
That's an awesome question. I think that, and maybe hard for me to answer. My overall goal in life is, and even when I was in the Navy, was to help impact a large audience in a positive way. That is my overall goal. That's what I want to do in some capacity for the rest of my life, right? So iteration, I mean, it really comes from my professional side of the house. We started Sukubi, I was the founding CEO. I wasn't probably the best suited from an aggressive operational standpoint to scale us. So I made a decision that was very impactful to the organization, to myself, to my family, to go maybe somewhere else that I could positively impact a large audience in a positive way, right? I went back into the agency space. I felt that I could help create stuff on the internet. I thought that was an exciting thing to do. I had my time there. That was impactful for me, impactful for those around me. I helped the brand. It was great. A lot of people, you know, grew from that. But then it was time to kind of step back and rethink that, right? So I think it's hard to pinpoint a specific time frame. I'm like, hey, I iterated here because of this, but you'll find those things as you go along, right? You continue moving towards that ultimate goal. So I think that vision, that overall long-term vision is important to what you asked there, but it's incremental in how you get there. I hope that helps.
Final question. How have you dealt with the loss of the Chargers?
I buy season tickets in Los Angeles. That's a tough one, man. I love San Diego, but I couldn't let my boys go. I have a strong relationship with that organization. My aunt, who passed away at 31, took me to my first game at the Murph when I was like,
nice.
I love San Diego. I spent many years out here when I was in the military. That attachment to that team is super meaningful to me. So they could have ended up in Nebraska. I probably would.
Any final questions?
Just, yeah. I got one.
Hey, you had talked about early on in your life when you left the Navy and then moved to Chicago and got laid off. So that was a pretty dark time. Were there any life skills that you had learned before that really helped you get out of that time? Because someone could go either way, like in that stage in their life, like they could give up or they could pick themselves up. And was there anything that you sort of learned early on in life that sort of helped you?
Most definitely. I learned that my kids eat a lot. Self-discipline is a big, important portion of that. And I think that is learnable if you stay consistent, and the military really helped me with that. You know, the technology side aside, right, I had some opportunities that found me because of my technical experience. But the discipline was driving, right? Complacency will kill you, man. You've got to keep pushing. And I think that was really what helped me through that phase. I ended up going into the physical security space, so web cameras was web related, and lots of products there, and that kind of. I kept the dialogue with Daniel going at that time, and the vision of how do we check websites for remote issues and potential points of compromise. This was a thing, and we just kept consistent with those items. As I was working, as I was transitioning back to California, it was really cold in Chicago too. kept that dialogue going, right? And the consistency of not staying complacent.
I might miss it. How did you transition into WordPress?
Wow, that's an awesome question. So I was stationed in Naples, Italy in 2004. I was doing design work, UI stuff, logo marks, branding on the side because the Navy pays real well, right? And I'm going, holy cow, I got all these cool graphics and stuff I'm making. I want to make a portfolio site. So I'm making this just terrible HTML and CSS website. And I'm like, I need a better way to manage this and use and all this stuff. And I started going through the gamut of like a